So, Casey, what's going on the track of this storm now?
Yeah, this storm has certainly brought us a lot of problems here over the past couple of hours here, and we've been watching for those tornadoes that we were watching, and now we're just looking at a lot of widespread rain all across the region. So what we're looking at right now, this is winds. Let me switch this back over here, though, to max one and...
Not want to switch?
Not quite there yet. Even the systems today don't want to keep up. You know, just when you need them, they're not working.
Yeah, it's not letting me switch on there.
All right, so we will take it to the key, and if we could pop up radar in the key right now. And that one's not working either, so.
Can we switch to max one?
There we go. All right. So now we'll take a look at what's going on across the region. So we've been dealing with a lot of heavy, widespread rainfall all across the region, and kind of zooming on out to take a closer look at how much rain we have seen so far. There's been a lot of rain so far from this system, especially off to our south and west near the Raleigh area, Rocky Mount, Henderson, over 3 inches of rain. Now for us, we've only really been looking at about a half an inch across those areas that are shaded in that blue coloring. That's either an inch or less. So even though it seems like it has been raining all day long, it really hasn't amounted to very much. The areas that are shaded in green, especially closer to Hosky and up towards Franklin, that's where we were tracking that tornado warning. And as it moved up, it was really dumping some heavy rainfall. So those amounts certainly verifying there with that tornado warning, the heavy rain that we were dealing with. And then across parts of even Elizabeth City, about an inch of rain there. Closer to the ocean front, there has been some heavier downpour. So we've seen about close to about a half an inch there, but elsewhere across Virginia Beach into Norfolk, Portsmouth, we were really only looking at less than an inch of rain. So certainly something that wasn't too terrible there. But if we go back and just take a more widespread view at this system and what has happened over the past couple of hours here, it has been lifting northward. You can see the center of the storm here, really closer to I-95, 85 there. And as it lifts northward, the heaviest of the rain hasn't been closer to the water, which is what we typically would see with a coastal storm as the system lifts northward. But it's been very scattered along the coastal areas, the heaviest of the rain towards those inland locations heading northward from there. And so as this lifts northward, we're going to still see some more rain. And so I'll turn it over to Jeff now to talk about kind of what's to come with this storm system and what are we going to expect here for the next 6-12 hours even.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks, Casey. And you were starting with, I was trying to nudge my way into talk about wind gusts. Obviously, that hasn't really been much of an issue across our area as we've gone throughout the day today. But the winds are picking up, and that was supposed to happen late in the afternoon into the evening. Check this out. Look at how the winds are starting to increase more to the south. We'll start to see the winds increasing more to the north as we go into the night ahead. This is what it looks like about an hour and 10 minutes from now. We could start to see some wind gusts across the Hampton Roads cities and stronger winds into North Carolina, where you may see gusts approaching 40 miles an hour. So that's coming into the evening. Virginia Beach, it'll start to get windy around sundown tonight. Into the peninsula, Wakefield towards the Middle Peninsula, probably not as windy into your areas. And then we'll see the wind likely out of the west or southwest into the overnight hours across the area as ELSA lifts to the north and it starts to move away from the region, when we'll start to see some improvement across our area. But tomorrow, not very windy. We're looking at sunshine. Should be a decent day. Here's a look at our future track for tonight. Casey just showed you where all the rain is and where it is heavy right now. And this is what it looks like for our evening ahead. Our model really picks up the rain and increases the amount of rain that comes out of the sky and out of the storm in the next 2 to 3 hours. So we have the rain that starts to pick up across the Hampton Roads cities around 7 p.m. Still raining pretty hard in some areas, especially around the Eastern Shore at 9 p.m. Notice the wind is stronger too. So the wind, the rain coming with ELSA for the evening. Later on tonight at 11 o'clock, we still have some rain across the Eastern Shore in Accomack County. But for the rest of the sector and for the rest of our area, it's looking pretty light. And it looks like the storm will be shutting down around midnight tonight or earlier for a lot of locations. So as you're going to bed tonight, if you're going to bed pretty late around 10 or 11, there's still activity for the Eastern Shore. But for the rest of the area, you can go to bed thinking, okay, well, that was ELSA. And now we're looking forward to our Friday. But with Friday, look at what we have in store for the afternoon. Thunderstorms start to develop during the afternoon and also into the evening. Our model really brings in a lot of heavy rain and some thunderstorms towards the evening as well. So that's one thing that we'll be watching for tomorrow. Some thunderstorms could pop up before the day ends. And then Saturday, looking pretty dry right now. Temperatures will be sitting in the 80s to near 90 degrees going into the weekend. For our day tonight, this should read for this evening. Downpours, tornado watch goes until 11 o'clock, and those wind gusts could be quite strong. Here's what our model thinks for extra rainfall on top of what we've already seen. And across the Hampton Road cities, we've only seen rainfall amounts of around a quarter of an inch. So we're going to add to that and maybe another inch or so on top of what we've seen across our area. Here's your 7-day forecast. Temperatures will be in the 90s for your Friday. Saturday, 88 degrees. Sunday, a high of 91 degrees with a slight chance for a couple of showers on Sunday. Monday, 93. Pretty hot going into next week. Low temperatures will be in the mid-70s. High temperatures will be in the low 90s with little chances for rain for next week.
All right, thanks, Jeff. Here is